Good evening, everyone. My name is Bhavya, and today I just want to be your focus on the COVID-19, the latest news. As we all know that coronavirus has taken a toll on the entire nation, and this pandemic has not only impacted our lives, but certainly our livelihoods as well by disrupting the whole economy. Today we will be having a discussion on coronavirus, the black swan event, and its likely impact on the economy with our finance expert Sharina Thamiza.
Have a brief discussion on coronavirus and its impact on the economy.
Hello everyone, this is Sharina, and today we're having a discussion on the burning topic of these times, coronavirus and its likely impact on the economy. In an evolving crisis, when nobody is able to say when it will be contained and what long-term impact it is likely to have on the economy, so it is likely to have a great stress on government, people and society at large, but the structural risk carries as much as economic risk as much as that of the biological risk if we see. So if I conclude, many people around the globe are comparing it and drawing a parallel of this coronavirus with the Great Depression of 1938, and the GDP of India is likely to fall below 4% this time. And in future, I expect that headwinds are likely to be more on the demand side as compared to the supply side, as the major contributors of GDP, that is the private consumption, exports and the investments, they are likely to suffer a lot, and they are likely to make GDP fall a lot in the coming future. And also, if I see, the saving grace has of course been technology during these times, since it has enabled a lot of people to work from home, but still our economy, a major part of our economy, unfolds offline. As per the snap poll conducted by CII, top line and bottom line are expected to fall a lot. Talking about unemployment, down the class pyramid, if we see, things are going to be way more desperate. And if we see the other things, like the seven ways that have been suggested by KPMG, the major focus has been on liquidity. Even it has been mentioned here that cash is the king for the businesses. KPMG is suggesting companies to maintain liquidity and to move towards the variable cost models. Even the recovery is likely to be phased out, because it will start initially in the services sector and then only it will move towards the manufacturing sector. In the last, I would like to conclude that this COVID-19 has posed fresh challenges to the businesses, and it needs a practical and measurable approach both from the businesses as well as from the government.